Good morning, dear students. In the last session, we mentioned about xylem, one of the complex tissue. And here, we can see the first dedifferentiated component in the xylem element is called tracheary elements. And the tracheary elements are highly specialized cells because it perform particular or specific functions in the anatomical level or in the physiological level in the plant body. So these are all, that is the tracheary elements are highly specialized. And here we can see the differentiation of tracheary element into two. That is, one is called as tracheids and the another one is called as vessels. So again, the tracheary element, that is the xylem tissue, is dedifferentiated into first as tracheary element, and the tracheary element is again dedifferentiated according to the structure or shape and specifically of their functions. So they are named as tracheids and the another one is vessel. So coming to the differentiation, both are more or less elongated cells. Even tracheary element is differentiated into tracheids and vessels, both are more or less elongated cells or elongated structure. And it is with means both tracheids and vessels with lignified walls. So the cell is the principal tissue, that is the xylem is the principal tissue or principal element differentiated, and they are primary as parenchymatous in origin. But later the cells of those tissue is getting more lignified. That is why the tracheid and vessels with the lignified walls, and they possess variety of pits. Variety of pits means the lignification of the secondary wall, which show varied nature of lignification. So there are certain unthickened areas or pockets which is developed in both tracheids and the vessels. So the walls which possess variety of pits or cavities and are non-living. So xylem having both the living cells and the dead cells. Here the tracheary element, the two types, tracheids and vessels, both are non-living cells. Because of the lignification, the cell become dead. And here we can see the first one, tracheary elements or tracheids. Tracheids are originated from a single cell. So the nature of origin is also different from between both the tracheids and vessels. Tracheids are originated from a single cell, that is single mother initial, and are imperforate with pairs on their common walls. So what is the anatomical differentiation between tracheids and vessels? Here tracheids, it is imperforated, there is no perforation. Perforation means the openings or only which show the pit pairs, pit unthickened lignified walls only on their lateral walls. There is no end plate and it do not show any perforation or openings other than that of pits. Okay, so here you can see the diagram of tracheid. Tracheids are more or less elongated cells. It is with the lignified outer walls, and it possesses a middle narrow lumen, and the walls or the common wall which show the presence of pit or openings or pit cavity. And another type of anatomical differentiation is it possesses, that is the tracheid possesses tapering end, but the ends are highly tapering. So it is a more elongated structure and it is with the tapering ends only they show what, the pit cavity or the common walls show the pit opening. There is no perforation, which is the first differentiation between tracheid and the vessels. Okay, and the second one is which is called vessel, and vessels are joined long tubes. So it is a tubular structure, it is more elongated in nature and of different length. So vessels proportionately it show slight variation in their length, but tracheids are usually almost the same in length. And here coming to the vessel, they arise from when the origin, that is, it is the vessels are arise from longitudinal row of cells and the end walls are perforated. So that is the difference between the tracheid and the vessel. That is, vessels are somewhat long tubes with a irregular in size and arise from the longitudinal row. That is because it is the vessels are the upward conducting canals or channels in the plant body. So from top, bottom to the top, the water or the minerals which are getting conducted through the vessels. So here the structurally we can see it arises as from the longitudinal rows of cells of the central cylinder of the plant body, that is the shoot system or root system, and the end walls are perforated. So to connect one above the other, the cells become, there is the end wall, and the end wall become perforated, means it is with the opening, because from one cell to the another one, that is from the bottom to the top, each and every vessels become connected, and which needs the transport or the flow of what, the sap material, because the perforation plates help to move sap. Sap means soil containing water and the minerals from one vessel to the other. So from the top bottom vessel to the upper vessel or nearby vessel, the sap material or the water and the minerals become transported through the vessel. So that is why the end plate is with a narrow opening, and which is called the perforation, and the end plate having the opening or pores or minute pores, and they are called as perforation plate. So this is the difference between the tracheids and the vessels. So structurally and functionally both are differentiated or de-differentiated, and both the tracheids and vessels coming under tracheary elements. Here you can see the diagram of vessel. It is with a somewhat elongated structure, and both the end wall, that is the lateral ends, which show the end plate, and the end plates are with the minute pores. Here you can see the minute pores are there in this side and the bottom side. So both the one vessel is getting connected between the nearby vessel element, and so the perforation plate which help to conduct the upward conduction of minerals or water, that is which is called as physiologically it is called as the sap material. So this is the structure of vessel. So this is the first de-differentiated element of xylem, which is called as tracheary elements. Okay, so we can see in the next session. Thank you.